Hey guys, Drew Rice here of Rice Running with another shoe review, and today I'll be reviewing the Saucony Peregrine 8. The Saucony Peregrine 8 is a neutral trail running shoe that has been around for many iterations and for many years has been a go-to for trail runners everywhere. I'm going to be going over the pros and the cons of this shoe that I've experienced while hiking and trail running in it over the past several months and give you my thoughts on whether or not it's something you might want to try. So let's get started with the review. So to start off with pros for the Saucony Peregrine 8, I've put a little over 200 miles in these shoes, and those miles have included some very rugged hikes and very rugged trail runs, mostly running throughout the Los Angeles National Forest area and the Sierra Nevada mountains, and I've had no accelerated wear on these. A large part of this durability is thanks to the outsole, which is what really shines with the Saucony Peregrine 8 and what attracted me to the shoe in the first place. Saucony calls this a power track outsole. And as you can see, it's a full-length rubber outsole with 6mm rubber lugs. These lugs have exceptional grip. That's the best thing about this shoe, is whether I'm bombing down a mountain on muddy trails or when I was hiking Half Dome the first time this year, hiking up a slick granite face, they have no problem gripping exceptionally smooth or exceptionally messy terrain. Everything that I've thrown at these, it's been able to handle with ample traction. As you can see, this is a pretty low profile shoe with a 24.5mm stack height in the heel and a 20.5mm stack height in the forefoot. This low drop coupled with the smooth transition of the outsole makes for a very comfortable ride. The midsole is made up of two separate layers, a Everrun topsole and a Powerfoam midsole. This combination makes for a very responsive and quick ride. I found it to be very resilient and to give my feet plenty of support and cushioning, bearing in mind that this is a neutral trainer, not a stability shoe. But for a neutral runner, it's going to give you all the support that you would desire when trail running. Also, in looking at the midsole, one thing that Saucony did in order to cut weight from this shoe was to remove the rock plate that would be in the midsole area of the foot in order to protect from stone bruises and other high impact discomfort. While some people prefer to have a rock plate in their trail running shoe, I think that this is actually a really good thing because the lug pattern gives enough distance between your foot and the terrain and allows for them to cut down weight, making this extremely grippy and protective shoe come in at 10 ounces even, which for a rugged trail running shoe that I would prefer for long trail races and ultras, I think that 10 ounces is a very competitive spot. Another important aspect to consider is that since this shoe is an iteration older, you will most likely have to get it online. Good thing about that is that the Saucony Peregrine 8 is true to size. I wear a size 9 in virtually every running shoe, and this is no exception. A 9 fits perfectly. One thing you might want to consider is that if you are a person that has wider feet, then these might not be the shoe for you because the midfoot is a little bit tighter than you might be used to. However, I've enjoyed that in this shoe. It's been good because it's kept my foot very secure when running across loose and uneven terrain. I like that, but that's going to come down to preference. As for the cons of the Saucony Peregrine 8, so the first con is the upper. Once you try running or hiking in these shoes, you'll notice that the upper is extremely breathable, which is great when it comes to running trails in the summertime or for water drainage when you have to go through a creek. However, it means also that this forefoot area especially is extremely porous. Not just in that it lets water in, it lets everything in. This is not an issue with gaiters or anything like that, letting dust in. I'm talking about anytime I wear these, the entire toe of the sock will be covered in dust. That's one thing that would be nice if they could kind of meet somewhere in the middle there. I love the breathability, but the lack of being waterproof and having such a porous upper, it just makes for slight inconvenience because you have to wash them out much more often than you would normally. And then going back to the midfoot being a little bit on the tight side, one thing you might want to consider is, while I haven't seen premature wear in the outsole or the midsole, I have noticed that on this area where the pinky toe touches up against, you'll notice that there's a little bit of wear there more than the rest of the upper. And that is a symptom of the midfoot being a little bit on the tight side. That being said, it doesn't cause any discomfort when I'm wearing them. It's just something you might want to be aware of. My last con is, I already mentioned the lack of the rock plate. Like I said, for me, not a deal breaker. I'm actually a fan of it, but some people, that is going to be a deal breaker, especially people that are using this for hiking and want more support. However, I will say that I've used this for multi-day hikes. I hiked Mount Whitney in it. I run on extremely rocky trails all the time in the mountains in these, and I've had no issues there. But for you rock plate enthusiasts, it doesn't have one. So what are my final thoughts on the Saucony Peregrine 8? Well, first thing is I got this online from runningwarehouse.com, and I purchased this pair for $50, which is absolutely insane. This is easily an $100 value shoe, and it has been amazing for me. I've used it on every type of hike you can imagine this year, and it has tackled everything with ease. It's a great budget hiking shoe. It gives you plenty of support, plenty of traction, especially if you're a trail runner that's hiking on the side. This is an amazing budget shoe. It's great on all terrain. Haven't had any issues with lack of grip. It's a joy to run in, actually. The ride and the weight make it feel like just a little bit of a beefed up version of a Kinvara. So it feels great tackling trails at a fast pace in these. I even like them so much that I ended up buying another pair so that whenever I run these out, I will have another one that I can use for training for an upcoming ultra. And they're amazing for running the mountains because they have such an aggressive feel. One piece outsole makes for a very smooth transition, both climbing and descending hills. And overall, they're just a really great shoe. And for the price point, you really can't beat it. They look great too, so it's a win in my book. And if you don't like the red, there's a little bit too much. It even comes with an extra set of gray laces. So for what that's worth, you've got that as an option. So that's all for the Saucony Peregrine 8. Like I said, I've absolutely loved having this shoe. Let me know whether or not you guys have tried it out, what you like about it, what you don't like, and give me any suggestions for other shoes to run trails or hike in, and I'll try to get videos out on those as soon as possible. And in the meantime, thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, all that fun stuff. Stay out on the trails, and I will see you guys next time.